Eternal Father, I offer you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the love and mercy of God be with you. Let us pray. Loving Father, you sent us your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to demonstrate to us your real image as a God full of love and mercy. Mercifully grant that we, your beloved children, may emulate the very example he demonstrated to us, that we may too become love and show mercy to our brothers and sisters. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke chapter 6, verses 27 to 38. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, I say to you that here, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. To him who strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from him who takes away your cloak, do not withhold your coat as well. Give to everyone who begs from you. And of him who takes away your goods, do not ask them again. And as you wish that men would do to you, do so to them. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For if you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. And if you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners. But love your enemies and do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. And your reward will be great, and you will be sons of the Most High. For he is kind to the ungrateful and the selfish. Be merciful, even as your Father is merciful. Judge not, and you will not be judged. Condemn not, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. Give, and to be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For the measure you give will be the measure you get back. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear good listener, I have chosen a question to be our theme. Are you worldly or godly? This theme helps us to examine ourselves whether we are different from those in the world or not. The gospel we have heard sets us a big challenge and asks you, do you act according to God's will or according to the world's whims? My dear good listener, in order to understand the text we have heard, we need to put in our midst the life of Jesus. What he says represents his life. Therefore, he becomes the way, the truth, and the life to live and to emulate. To his beloved children, he tells the way to follow and the way to shun. Jesus tells his disciples, I say to you that hear. In the biblical sense, hearing means doing. It is an active hearing that puts into practice what has been heard. Jesus gives us the list to follow if we are to call ourselves Christians. He begins by telling us, love your enemies. My dear good listener, do you have enemies? I imagine your answer is yes. Back to our theme, are you worldly or godly? Let us look at the characteristics that distinguish the two. According to the biblical sense, being worldly means being concerned with worldly affairs, especially the neglect of spiritual things. The person who is worldly conforms himself or herself to what is in the world than what is of God. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 1 to 3, St. Paul tells his listeners, brothers, I could not address you as spiritual, but as worldly, mere infants in Christ. You are still worldly. For instance, there is jealousy and quarreling among you. Are you not worldly? Are you not acting like mere men? Therefore, according to this text, a person is worldly, is not led by God's will, but by his or her selfish interest. Friends of the world lack intimacy with God. They prefer what is in the world than what belongs to God. Friends of the world lack generosity in their offerings to God's people. They also have compromised morals, especially when in difficult moments. They will sacrifice their families for cultural and political status. Friends of the world lack spiritual influence. They are reluctant to give up sin. For Catholics, such people will never go for confession. They look at it as a wastage of time. Friends of the world are materialistic. What counts for them is the material, not the spiritual gain. They do not fear God. My dear good listener, having understood the person who is worldly is, we cannot but understand where today's gospel. According to Jesus, people who are not Christians become worldly. Such people hate and do not forgive, will curse and revenge on those who hurt them. They will demand to be paid back on everything from their offenders. They are not generous to those who are in need. They treat others not according to how they themselves would wish to be treated. In other words, they are selfish. They are not merciful. They are judgmental. They condemn others and forget that they are equal sinners in need of God's mercy and forgiveness. They do not forget and forgive. They harbor anger and revenge in their hearts. My dear good listener, are you one of this category? Jesus today is asking you, are you a Christian? Do you think you can be a Christian just because you practice religious rituals like going to church every Sunday, paying tithe, giving offertory, saying the rosary, praying three times a day like the other Pharisee, attending vigil prayers all night? My dear good listener, these are good manifestations of our Christian faith. But Jesus is telling us that if we are not godly, these remain empty practices without the heart. We end up becoming Pharisees and scribes who never practiced what was godly. According to the dictionary, a godly person is someone who is deeply religious and shows obedience to the rules of their religion. Therefore, when Jesus says, forgive your enemies, you really forgive and not do the reverse. My dear good listener, in a summary form, the Christian religion is about two things, love and mercy. Jesus reveals to Saint Faustina that he is love and mercy itself. And in today's gospel, he challenges us about who a Christian is. He asks us, if you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. Therefore, to put in other words to understand what Jesus is saying, if a witch or a murderer or a thief hates his enemies and loves his friends, fellow witches, murderers, and thieves, and you as a Christian, you go to church, you practice all that were said before, but you also have enemies whom you hate and do not greet, are you any different from a witch, a murderer, or a thief? The answer is no, because you are worldly like them. You and them have similar principles that guide life. You love as they love, but you hate as they hate. Therefore, you are the same. The only difference is you go to church, I go to church. Therefore, according to Jesus, you are only different from these when you love all people without distinction, and when you show mercy to the bad and the good, just like God the Father does. Two things, according to today's gospel text, will differentiate you from those who are worldly. First, when you treat others the way you would wish them to treat you. And secondly, when you become loving and merciful like God is. Jesus told Saint Faustina in her diary number 1488 the way that she ought to emulate. My child, there is no way to heaven except the way of the cross. I followed it first. You must learn that it is the shortest and surest way. And I also add, it is the shortest and surest way because through the way of the cross, Jesus manifested to us true love and mercy. And the true love is sacrifice. Doing good to the other, not something I will get from the other. In the same spirit, therefore, may you continue to pray that the loving and merciful God may stop the spread of coronavirus and heal those especially who are suffering from it. The Lord be with you. May the God of love and mercy bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.